Hi, this is Dennis. I'm going to show you today on how to install Agimat and of course on how to trade Agimat. Okay, this is the version 2018. Why? I do release every year a new version of Agimat. Yeah, last year it was the version 2017 and the year before it was the version 2016. So, why I do this? Why I release each year a new version? Because the previous version is not working? No, this is not the reason. The reason is very simple. Each year I adjust my software to market conditions. Okay, market conditions are changing. And of course, to keep a software successful, you have to adjust the software regarding the market conditions. Okay, it is a very simple formula. If someone has developed a software in 2010, I can assure you the software won't be anymore that profitable in 2018 as the software was in the beginning. Yeah, so this is the reason why I release every year, mostly between February and May, a new version of all my software products. It does not matter if it's Agimat or the Harmonic Scanner or the EA. Yeah? Okay, but now today we talk about the Agimat software. So if you have purchased the software, then thank you for your trust and congratulations. Then you have received a Windows installer. Okay, so if you're a Mac user like me, yeah, I have my whole trading environment is running on Apple. But how do I use a Windows installer on my Mac? In this example, I use a Mac, as you can see here. How do I do this? Very easy to answer. I use the only working and stable solution to run Windows apps on Mac. And the solution calls Parallel Desktops. Okay? Believe me, this is the only stable solution. Of course, both we know there are a lot of open source software out there, even for free, like a Wine Bottler or Play on Mac. But the software is open source, it has an open source code, everyone can change their something. And do you really trust Forex live account with an unstable open source software like Wine Bottler, for example? I do not do this. And even though the installation of Agimat on Wine Bottler is very complicated, but of course it is working and you can do this. And if you insist using your third party tools because you have good experience with it, then go ahead, of course, no problem at all. But then most likely you have to contact me and I need to send you, instead of the Windows installation wizard, I have to send you the files of Agimat for manual installation. Yeah, this will be like 7 or 6 EX4 files, a DLL file, the template, etc., etc. Okay. But for now, we have the Windows installation, and to install Agimat, you just do a double click. So now, some Windows Windows versions like Windows 10, or your virus scanner, or your local firewall, or your Windows Defender, they might give you a warning when you execute Agimat. This warning you can simply ignore. The Agimat installation wizard is not harmful and it's not containing a virus or something. But why do you get this warning in the first place? Because I have not code signed my installer with Microsoft and I'm not doing this. The fee is exorbitant high, Microsoft want to get. And it is just that Microsoft is agreeing that my installer is not harmful. This is just ridiculous, okay? So if there's popping up a warning, simply ignore it and run the installation. Nothing will happen. Yeah. So let's do it. Double click. So then just say next. Of course, some informations. Next. You say next. You have to accept. Sorry. Risk warning, of course, we all know in Forex there are risks involved, but you know this. Then the license user agreement, it's the same, it's just the standard blah 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 you get with any piece of software. Next. So now, after your purchase and during your purchase, you had to register your MT4 account ID. MT4 account ID. Yeah, so if you have more than one broker, and I have, then please keep in mind to install the software on the correct account you have registered. Okay, so if you have, or you are allowed to register two MT4 account IDs. Yeah. Also, you can change your account ID anytime by letting me know and I will issue a new license. No problem at all. Or you have registered just one account ID after a purchase and, like, for example, 2 weeks later you want to have a second account. Don't worry, please contact me, provide your new ID and I will issue a new account, a new license for you. Oh my god, I cannot get it straight. Sorry, it's very early here. So, in my case, I use this account today for the installation. Say next. Next. Okay, installation, it's done. It's very quick. You see, you cannot do anything wrong. It's very easy. Then start your MT4. Great. After starting MT4, please open any chart. Let's take UC for example. I go to 1 hour time frame. So then, to apply the template, yes, of course, you have to apply the template first. Yeah. Sometimes I get messages from people. They have installed Agimat and then they open MT4 and telling me, Agimat is not working. Then, of course, the first thing I'm asking for is a screenshot. And then they're sending me a screenshot just with a plain chart. It is very important that you watch the videos I'm doing, okay? Only if you watch the videos complete, you will understand on how to install Agimat and on how to trade. Yeah, it is very important. Please. Always take the time and watch the videos complete. So, if you're really serious in trading, then you will have 20 minutes or 30 minutes time to watch the video. Okay? So, you have two ways to apply the template. You have a button here, templates. Okay, but it depends on your settings. Maybe you have deleted this tool line, this toolbar here. Then you just do a right click on the chart. Template and load this one here, Agimat FX 2018 Pro Plus. Okay, here we go. Done. It's loaded. So your template need to look like this. If there's something missing, if the colors are different, then you have made something wrong. Also, if you're very important, if you have an error message in this area here, okay, above the copyright, like here, if there's a black text and it's telling something similar like Agimat license not valid for account ID, yeah, then you simply reload your chart again. Why this message appears in the first place? It appears because your MT4 could not establish a connection to my neural network. and then you will get an error message. Also, very important, please save this in your head from the very beginning. Always close shards before closing MT4. Never ever close MT4 with open shards. And especially not with the Agimar template. If you have tons of shards open and apply the Agimar template, and then you just shut down your MT4 without closing the shards before, the next time you will reopen MT4 with the saved shards, you will have an error message on each shard that the Agimat license is not valid and the neural network connection could not be established. Each time you're starting your MT4 and you want to use Agimat, you need to open a fresh shard and you need to apply the template. Only in this way I can guarantee is a fresh and stable connection to my systems. This is very, very, very important, okay? But all we know, you know, I mean, all we are lazy. So it's just easy to close MT4 and not closing the shards before. But then, yeah, you have the consequences. You won't have any fresh data. So always close the shards before closing MT4, okay? And then everything will be easy. Also, my drawing tool. So, if you get a different message here on this area, it's telling a license has been expired, then there's a reason for, okay? Meaning, you have a pirated version, of course, then I have not activated your account. If you have a legit purchased version of Agimat, and you get a license expired message, please contact me. I will pre-check with my license management if you really have purchased Agimat, and then I will just issue a new license. No problem at all. Okay. Okay. How do we trade? Let me open again shards. GU again. 1 hour. Yes, I just did the break and I have closed the shards because I just ate something. Sorry. Then let's also open one more examples. Let's say a lower time frame. So here we have two good examples, okay? So or let's just take one pair. Let's take one pair and two time frames. It is better. So. Okay. What kind of information do you see on the chart? Yeah, you have these yellow boxes. And you have yellow boxes with black arrow. And of course you have the white arrows. What does this mean? So the yellow boxes with the black arrow will show you reversal information, meaning the price is going like this, the shards. Okay, reversals. Okay. If here the black arrow with yellow boxes, here, 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 here. Yeah, on higher time frames. These actions will take a while, very obviously, okay? Because you're trading on higher time frames, so it can run several days, even weeks. But of course, the amount of pips you're going to harvest in these time frames are also huge. Yeah, it's very easy to understand. Higher time frames, longer trades, more pips. Shorter time frame or smaller time frames, shorter trades, smaller pips. Yeah, very obviously. So, okay. I just explained you the yellow box with the black arrow. Reversals. Now, what are the yellow boxes without black arrow? These ones. Oops, my drawing tool. These ones. These are pullbacks within the reversal. Okay? Like this. So, the reversal took place here. Yellow box with the black arrow. So, then you will have a pullback within the reversal. Like this. Reversal take place here. Here are pullbacks. Okay, these are pullbacks. You can see it here. Exactly as I described. And here is again a pullback. And since reversal has taken place here, the trend is bullish. But on the way, on the long trade, you will have reversals. It's very obviously, it happened all time, okay? This is what the dealer and the market makers are doing, because they are booking profit with these let's say zigzag trades, yeah? So, but in your case, I do not suggest trading reversals. This is not what I'm explaining here. You have to trade only the yellow boxes with the black arrow. Only these trades. Only the yellow box with the black arrow will give you a reversal information. But when the yellow box with the black arrow appear on your chart, the trade is not yet confirmed. Okay, do not enter the trade on this here, on this box. Do not do this. You enter your trade after seeing this, the yellow box with the black arrow. Then you wait for the white arrow to confirm the reversal. Okay. After getting the white arrow, you will receive an alert message. It's telling the currency pair, the price, and if it's long or short, I mean buy or sell. So then you still wait after getting this white arrow, okay? The white arrow will appear with this candle. The arrow will appear immediately with this candle and not after the candle is done painting. The arrow will appear immediately. You wait. And then you see this line here, the yellow line. This is the Agimat Angular Momentum. It is not a moving average. Okay? It is not a moving average. I will just show you in a few minutes why it is not a moving average. It is something very different. This line, it looks so harmless, but it is a very robust beast. Okay? You have to take this line all time for your trades. Why? You execute your trades on the first candle, this one, in this case it's a bullish. Take your trades on the first candle above the AAM line. After getting this and this. Okay, the rules are very simple. First, wait for the reversal. Wait for the yellow box with the black arrow. Wait for the white arrow. The white arrow will give you an alert. Then have a look to Maxwell's equation indicator. The trend need to be synced with this movement. You need to see the same movement here in the future prediction, okay? Because what you see here, okay, in this example, so let's say we have, now let's make it a bit better. So this is what we see, okay? So let's now say the current price is here. So this, it doesn't exist here. But the future prediction will show you still the future outcome of the volume, of the trading volume. And the future prediction need to show in the same direction you're trading. You have the yellow box with the black arrow, you get the white arrow, you wait the price to run over the AAM, you execute your trade with the first candle above. And this is this one. Everything is confirmed. The future prediction, it's showing your long trade, and here everything is confirmed. Execute your trade. Showing you a better example. I know it might confuse you right now, but believe me, it is very easy to understand. You do it a few times and then you're okay. Let's go to a smaller time frame. So, here we have a perfect example. Look at this. Reversal has taken place. So, as you can see here, this is the current price. And this is the future prediction, right? This is the... let me move my cursor away there. So, now... So, this is the current price. But the future prediction, it's showing something very different. Meaning, not valid. If you have the current price like this, the future prediction is showing a clear long. You can execute your trade because you got here the yellow box with the black arrow, the confirmation for the reversal, and this candle has closed just short above the AMA, but it is valid. The trade is valid here. And as you can see, no pullback, nothing, and you have still made your pips. But of course, you're trading in 5 minutes time frame. Obviously, no? The trade cannot run like 2 hours or like the half day. 5 minutes time frame, it's scalping. You execute your trade here and you let it run maybe for 10, 15 pips. This is scalping on lower time frame. Swing trading, you can do here on this time frames. Everything that is 5 minutes until 30 minutes is forex scalping. This is how I do it. So, again, in this case, you saw the candle here. The future prediction is showing you a bullish execute. Here, for this current trade, what we have right now, the future prediction does not confirm. So, you do not execute the trade here. In this example, okay, not valid. Actually, it's very nice. I can show you right now a not valid trade. In this case, yellow box, you got reversal take place. The white arrow confirms the reversal. You get an alert with the white arrow telling you something like sell the currency pair and the price. You wait. You have here the AMA. You wait for the first candle close below the AMA, or closes below, or no, starts to paint. Whoops, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I have just a problem here with my... Oops, I'm sorry. I can exit this now. Ah, no. Okay, perfect. So, back. Again, I'm sorry. You get the white, the yellow box with the black arrow, the white arrow. Wait for the first candle to start below the AMA. Execute the trade here with this candle. Execute. If the future prediction is confirming the trade, and it does. Okay, this is what you see. This is the price. So, this future prediction you will see. You still have a very clear short trend. Okay, confirmed. Trade. Execute your order for 10 to 20 pips or even more. This is always depends on your scalping strategy. Okay. So, in this case, let's have this example here again. Why this trade does not work out? You have your yellow box with the black arrow. You have the white arrow. You have the first bar. After the white arrow starts to paint above the AMA, this one. So then you look down to the future prediction. It just looks very messy. There is no really clear long trend. It just is sideways, okay? As you really can see it here, very clear. Nothing that's really going on. And as you can see here, what the price is doing right now, it reverses. Okay, there's a pullback. The pullback might run, I guess, more or less until here. And then it will reverse. So, if you do not care about heavy drawdown, then of course you can still execute the trade. But it is not what I recommend, okay? The trade, in my case, the trade is not valid. Because the future prediction is not valid at all. Everything needs to fit. You have to check. Okay, again. Easy rules. Reversal take place. You can trade or you can scalp on lower time frame if you get the yellow box with the black arrow. If the white arrow appear, then check the AAM, I'm sorry, and wait for the first candle to start painting above. It's this one. Okay, check the future prediction. It looks very very clear to me. Okay, easy rules, very easy to understand. Here the same in this case. It is very important that the future prediction, it's giving you something very clear. If you see something like this, it is not clear. If you see that something like this, it's not clear. Okay, there need to be really a very obvious movement. Like this. Not like this. It's not working. Not valid. Okay? Agimat, it's getting extreme accurate if you go in higher time frames. Yeah, if you can see it here, look at this, it's just beautiful. In this case, the reversal has taken place here. You see this? It's amazing. So, now you might ask, for how many pips you should go? Well, this is always depends about you. Okay, everything is different, and I'm not explaining money management to you because everyone has a totally different understanding of money management. But if you execute a trade here and you just wait for the next pullback here, you would have made at least 151 pips. Okay, so at least 151 pips, as you can see here. So I do not know when the last previous reversal took place, but if you just take this here until the next reversal, then we are in 680 pips. But most people don't have the nerves, okay, to let the trade run like 2 weeks or one half month, okay. I do this sometimes. And yeah, it is still worth it, okay? I mean, why I should execute 3 trades each day, making their 15 pips. If I can have a trade running, let's say for 1 month or a bit longer, and making the 900 pips. Okay, this is... But not everyone can stand trading like this. Yeah, of course, you always have a bit pullback and drawdown. But once you reach the run, okay, of course, there is no drawdown anymore. It's just going up and down with the pullbacks a bit. But in the end, you just wait for the next reversal. And then you exit your trade. Then you have enough. You just, yeah, or you enter a next trade, or you just trade lower time frames again. It's all up to you. Okay, so I have just explained the rules. They're very simple. You just wait for the yellow box with the black arrow. You wait for the white arrow to appear and the alert message. You have a look to the future prediction. Need to line up very obviously, not sideways. And you execute the trend. If you go long, the first candle above the AAM, the yellow line you see there, and if you go short, the first candle below the AAM, after the white arrow, after the yellow box with the black arrow, with confirmation of the future prediction. Okay, very easy. So now, some people might say, hey, you just have put your simple moving average and now you're telling this is so robust and stable. Again, the yellow line is not a moving average. As you can see it here, let's take the standard value of 13. Do this look like a moving average? No, it does not. You see, they're very different. Let's remove it again. Indicator list. Moving average. So, and then for the advanced traders, you see here the black lines, right? These are market maker swing zones. Market makers and dealer will use these price lines all time to consolidate the price and to swing away from these prices and to use these price lines for stop hunting. So just have a look here. Let's say this line here. This is value. the price accumulates, is accumulating very heavy. Next line, the same. It always happens on these lines. Swing take place on these lines. Pullback takes place on those lines. Accumulation phase. Here, lower time frame. Just see it. Do you see this? And this is not by random. You can take a ton of charts, apply the Agimar template in higher time frame than lower time frame, and you will see this behavior all time. These lines, they're not moving. They are fixed, printed on the chart. They are not moving, they are not repainting, they're just fixed. And you can watch the price always consolidating and swinging away on these lines. Because behind these lines, even though they look very, very harmless, just like some simple lines, but the values behind these lines, the numbers, they are extreme powerful, and they are used by dealers every day, every time. You might hear it already of the daily trading range, the weekly trading range. Yeah, it has something to do with the lines, but I don't want to go so much into detail because it will just confuse you. But as you can see, these lines are very powerful, and you even though could incorporate these market maker swing zones with your trading, of course. So if you go on higher time frames, extreme high time frames, on the daily, you see what happened here? Do you see what happened here? I mean, I can repeat it over and over again, okay? I cannot go back in history. It will, with the charts, it will happen over and over again. You see? Just think about this in your trading strategies when using the confirmations I have just explained to you. Yeah? You can also incorporate the market maker swing zones, okay? See this? It's all time, and it will happen over and over again. Yeah? You cannot prevent the price from swinging away and consolidating on the market maker swing zones. So, if you get now on the swing zone, the yellow box with the black arrow, the white arrow, and everything is lining up here, and this happen on the market maker swing zone, man, you can be sure this is a very safe trade, okay? You can be sure. You can be very sure. So, see this. the price hits a market maker swing zone and you get all the confirmations here I was talking about. Incorporate the market maker swing zones in your trading. Just do it and you will be successful. I really can promise you this if you follow these simple rules. These rules are so straight, so simple, so easy to understand. I have put a lot of effort to keep the Agimat charts clean. Clean, not messed up with some information you just do not need. Okay? Only if you have a clean and simple strategy, you can be successful and you will be successful. Just follow, please, follow my simple rules. Do not make your own stuff up and you will be successful. Okay? So, I guess I'm done. I have explained everything. If you have more questions, you just send me please an email. Please, an email. If you send me a Facebook message on Instagram, it might take a while until I come back to you. Because my Facebook is private and only I can access my Facebook, very obviously. But if you send an email, I have employees, they're also replying to the emails. So anyone will always reply and this will happen all time within 24 hours, most likely earlier. Okay, but it is important that you send an email and not a private Facebook message. Then if I'm on travel or with my family, I'm not reading my Facebook messages. Of course not. Okay. Okay, great. Please watch the video even the second time to really understand it, to understand everything. And if you get more questions, you just can ask me anytime by email and I will come back to you or someone will come back to you from my team. And we can figure out your problem and we can help you. Okay, thank you so much and bye bye.